This is the story of an outback dog, said to be a rabbiter but never got the job. To Rowie the stop in the southern state, where a railway man saw a cheery little face. For Will and his wife, life wouldn't be the same. Five Bob bought the dog, a home and a name. But little did they know that their raggy brown friend would become a legend with the railway men. This scruffy little dog with the crooked grin won the hearts of the railway men. Travelled on the trains with the whistle and the steam. Little dog's life was a little dog's dream. Had a collar made of leather with a small brass plate. Embossed was the motto of his railway mates. Stop me not, let me jog, for I am Bob, the driver's dog. The cheery little friend of the railway men, Bob, the railway dog. Up and down platforms through the rail yards, knew he was coming by his cheery little bark. The Petersburg travellers got the meet and greet from the shaggy little dog with the busy little feet. Every chance he'd get, he'd travel on the trains, in and out of town through the open plains. From the coal tender, Bob got the best of views. He'd yodel and he'd bark as the whistle blew. This scruffy little dog with the crooked grin won the hearts of the railway men. As he travelled on the trains with the whistle and the steam, a little dog's life was a little dog's dream. Had a collar made of leather with a small brass plate. Embossed was the motto of his railway mates. Stop me not, but let me jog, for I am Bob, the driver's dog. Cheery little friend of the railway men, Bob the railway dog. In Adelaide, Bob had a favourite little stop, Mr. Evans and his Hindley Street butcher shop, where a couple of snags would fill the space in the tummy of a dog with a hungry little face. With his belly full, he was back to the yards, wagging his tail across the rails he'd charge. With his tongue hanging out and a mile-wide grin, Bob's back on the trains again. He could sense danger, comfort a stranger, just took it in his stride as he went. A gentle companion to everyone that knew him, Bob knew his place as a man's best friend. He was one in a million to all he had known, this little brown dog with no fixed abode. Hindley Street, the final resting place for the shaggy little dog with the bright little face. Mr. Evans said, boy, you finally come home, time to rest those weary little bones. There was silence in the yards when a long whistle blew. Bob's time had come, the railmen knew. This scruffy little dog with the crooked grin, who won the hearts of the railway men. No more would travel with the whistle and the steam. A little dog's life had come to an end. But on a collar made of leather with a small brass plate, he's remembered forever by the words of his mates. Stop me not, but let me jog, for I am Bob, the driver's dog. The cheery little friend of the railway men, Bob, the railway dog.